Blessings be upon Nabi, peace be upon the messenger, and the prophets who were sent, all of them were honored. As-salatu ala Nabi, was-salamu ala Rasul, wal-anbiya'i al-mursalin, kulluhum.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه الحمد لله كما يحب ربنا ويرضى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد Dear respected brothers and sisters, let me ask you a question in the beginning of this episode. How do you become aware of something around you? How do you know about what is useful for you and what is harmful for you? How to know about what is good, what is bad? How to be aware of things? How to know how to run things? How to know how to operate things? The only way is to learn, is to study. That's why we need education. That's why Sharia encouraged us to learn. And to keep studying, in fact. And we see that Sharia encouraged learning and studying in general, and Sharia in particular encouraged us to learn Islamic knowledge. And of course, if we want to reach to an acceptable level of Islamic knowledge, we need to learn the basics. And the basics is how to read, how to write, and how to listen carefully, studying in general. So, ilm, education, is one of the recommended acts by Sharia, generally speaking. That's why today's statement, which is a statement by Makhul. Makhul is a Makhul al-Dimashqi. He was a Mawla. He used to be, his father was a slave, and then he was freed. So he had allegiance to the people who had freed him, and this shows that the way the prisoners of war used to be dealt with according to the Islamic system is the best way to deal with prisoners of war, because you are going to encourage them to know or to follow or to see the benefits of Islam and to see Islam in its reality, and that what has happened that time. And that's why we found that there were many scholars whom their parents were slaves and they were freed, or they were slaves, they were taken as prisoners of war, or their grandparents were taken as prisoners of war, and then they become Muslim. The children became scholars, such as Makhul. Makhul, he is known as Makhul al-Shami, and he is from Dimashq. May Allah Jalla wa Ala free Dimashq from the oppressors, and may Allah Jalla wa Ala give the Mujahideen there the victory. Makhul al-Shami said that he traveled everywhere in the world to seek knowledge. Al-Dhahabi said that might be exaggeration, but it means that he traveled in most of the countries that he or a person can travel to in order to seek knowledge himself. That's why he had a very beautiful statement about seeking knowledge. He said that seeking knowledge, or the one who goes to seek knowledge, he will be in the path of Jannah until he comes back. This is exactly the same hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, when he said man salaka tariqan yaltamisu bihi ilman sahhala Allahu lahu bihi tariqan ila al-jannah. This is a very long hadith. I will read the full hadith for you, my dear respected brothers and sisters, because it is a very important hadith. This hadith was narrated by Qais ibn Kathir. He said a man came to Abu Darda radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, while Abu Darda, who was one of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was in Dimashq. He was living in Dimashq. And he said Abu Darda told him, why are you coming? He said, I came because I knew that you were narrating a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. I did not come to have business. I did not come to do anything else. I came for one reason, which is what? To hear this hadith from you, subhanallah. To hear this hadith from you. Then Abu Darda radiallahu ta'ala anhu was pleased. And then Abu Darda narrated the following hadith. He said to him, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam saying, من سلك طريقا يلتمس به علما سهل الله له طريقا إلى الجنة or سهل الله له به طريقا إلى الجنة. The one who takes a path to seek knowledge, Allah Jalla wa Ala will facilitate for him, for whatever he did, a tariq, a path to paradise. So the one who takes a path to seek knowledge, Allah Jalla wa Ala will give him a path or will facilitate for him a path to Jannah. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam said, وَإِنَّ الْمَلَائِكَةَ لَتَضَعُ أَجْنِحَتَهَا لِطَالِبِ الْعِلْمِ In other riwayah, ridan bima yasna. The malaika, the angels, they put their wings, they unfold their wings in order to welcome talib al-ilm, in order to show pleasure for talib al-ilm, for what he is doing. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, wa innal alima la yastaghfiru lahu man fi as-samawati wa man fi al-ard. The alim, everyone in the world seeks forgiveness for him. Everyone in the heavens and in the world, in the earth, seek forgiveness or seeks forgiveness for who? For al-alim. In the other hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, everything seeks forgiveness for the person who is seeking, for the alim, for the scholar, including the ant in their holes, and including the fish in the sea. Subhanallah. Including the ant in the hole, in their hole, and the fish in the sea. They are what? Seeking forgiveness for talib al-ilm, for al-alim. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam said, فَضْلُ الْعَالِمِ عَلَى الْعَابِدِ The status of the alim over the status of the abid who does not know is like the status of the qamar above the other planet, the other planets or stars. As you know that the qamar is of a high status because of its position, because of its beauty, because of its benefit, and so on. So the status of the alim over other people who do not know is like the status of the qamar over the other stars, the status of the moon over the other stars. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَإِنَّ الْعُلَمَاءَ وَرَثَةُ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ The scholars are the inheritors of who? Of the anbiya, the prophets. And the anbiya did not leave any money or any wealth. They left the ilm. And whoever takes the ilm, he has really take something in abundance. Subhanallah al-Azim. This is how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam praised al-ilm and the people of knowledge, and the people who are seeking knowledge is a very comprehensive hadith. And my dear respected brothers and sisters, Allah Jalla wa Ala commanded us to refer to the people of knowledge if we don't know. فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ Ask the people of knowledge if you don't know. And they said that when Allah Jalla wa Ala says, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكِ Allah Jalla wa Ala commanded us to learn, and then what? فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ and استغفر لِذَنْبِكِ Because you need to know who Allah is, and you need to believe in Allah Jalla wa Ala. How to believe in Allah Jalla wa Ala? You need to know Allah Jalla wa Ala. You need to know that Allah Jalla wa Ala is one. Then you believe in it, and then you seek forgiveness. Sufyan al-Thawri said, Allah Jalla wa Ala commanded us to act after we learn. after we learn. And that's why Imam Bukhari in his Sahih said, بَابٌ بَابٌ الْعِلْمُ بَعْدَ الْعِلْمُ قَبْلَ الْقَوْلِ وَالْعَمَلِ. Babun, a chapter of ilm, that ilm is needed before we say or before we act. Allah Jalla wa Ala also says in the Quran, فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَ الْأَبْصَارُ وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَ الْقُلُوبُ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. Indeed, the absar that do not go or grow blind. Indeed, what grow blind is what is the hearts in the breasts. What does that mean? It means that the person might be blind, but his heart is alive and his heart can see things out of what? It is a knowledge. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala says about the Quran, بَلْ هُوَ آيَاتٌ بَيِّنَاتٌ فِي صُدُورِ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمِ. The Quran is just signs, clear signs and proofs in the hearts of the people who were given knowledge. Allah also says, أَفَمَنْ يَعْلَمُ أَنَّمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ الْحَقُّ كَمَنْ هُوَ أَعْمَى إِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرُ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. Allah Jalla wa Ala divided the people into two types. The people who know the truth that has been revealed by Allah Jalla wa Ala and the blind people. Some people of knowledge said that this means that the one who does not take the ilm that came from Allah Jalla wa Ala, this person is a blind, because Allah Jalla wa Ala divided people into two types. The one who knows that what has been revealed unto Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam from his Lord is not like the one who does not know anything about what has been revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. That's why al-ilmu nur. Al-ilm is a light. Let us have a break and we continue, insha'Allah, after the break. Assalamu alaikum.
Salatu ala al-Nabi wa salamu ala al-Rasul wal-Anbiya'i al-Mursaleen kulluhum mukramun.
To be the best and give his best religion to them. Allah our God is the greatest, the one and only glory to him. He born in you.
Al-Imam al-Nawawi, may Allah have mercy on him, have indeed did a great and a tremendous job in compiling some of the most beautiful ahadith and the relevant ayat in one of his marvelous works, which is known as Riyad al-Salihin, or Gardens of the Pious. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all amongst the dwellers of Gardens of the Pious. Jannat al-Na'im. Allahumma ameen.
صلاة على النبي والسلام على الرسول والأنبياء المرسلين كلهم مكرمون.
بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الله جل وعلا says in the Quran, إن الذين أوتوا العلم من قبله إذا يتلى عليهم يخرون للأذقان سجدا ويقولون سبحان ربنا إن كان وعد ربنا لمفعولا ويخرون للأذقان يبكون ويزيدهم خشوعا. The translation of this ayah is as follows. Say, O Muhammad, to them, believe in it or not, believe in the Quran or do not believe in the Quran. Verily, those who were given knowledge before the Quran was revealed. Who are those people? They are the Jews and Christians, because they were given this Quran, this knowledge before the Quran. When the Quran is recited to them, they fall down on their faces in humble prostration. Some scholars said that this ayah refers to the likes of Salman al-Farisi, because they had knowledge that there is something is about to come. So when the Quran was revealed to them, they believed in the Quran and they fell into prostration, or they fell down on their faces in humble prostration. This means what, my dear respected brothers and sisters? That ilm guides to what? Guides to the truth. Ilm guides you to follow the right path. And if you are misguided, it is mainly because you do not have knowledge. Mainly. It is not the only reason. There are some other reasons for the person not to be misguided. The main reason, or one of the main reasons, is what? That he did not have knowledge. That's why, if you study, then you will be guided. The more you study, the more you will be guided. And that's why the more you study, provided that you are studying in a sincere way to know the truth, to follow the truth, you will be guided. And not only you will be guided, the iman will increase. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala says, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Indeed, those who fear Allah Jalla wa Ala are the scholars. Or if you can say, those who have knowledge or the scholars, are those who fear Allah Jalla wa Ala. That's why Sufyan al-Thawri radiyallahu ta'ala anhu used to say, لَيْسَ طَلَبِ الْعِلْمِ فُلَانْ عَنْ فُلَانْ. It is not طَلَبِ الْعِلْمِ to say, oh, I know that this hadith was narrated by so-and-so and so-and-so. He said, indeed, العلم الخشية لله. Indeed, العلم is fear of Allah Jalla wa Ala. And Masruq, one of the students of Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha, used to say, كَفَى بِالْمَرْءِ عِلْمًا أَنْ يَخْشَى اللَّهِ. It is sufficient for the person to fear Allah Jalla wa Ala as ilm. So, because ilm is khashya. The ilm is khashya. What does that mean? It doesn't mean that, okay, if you fear Allah Jalla wa Ala without knowledge, then you have encompassed knowledge. No. Other scholars explain this by the real ilm is to learn something and to act upon it. To learn something and to act upon it. And that was the habit of the companions. May Allah Jalla wa Ala be pleased with them. That was the habit of the tabi'in. That was the habit of all scholars. Imam Ahmad one time hosted a person who was seeking knowledge. And he was seeking hadith. And Imam Ahmad left some water for him during the night. And in the morning, Imam Ahmad noticed that this person did not use the water. It means that he did not make wudu to pray the night prayer. He said, how come a talib ilm does not pray at night? How come a talib ilm does not pray at night? And they said that Imam Ahmad used to act upon every single hadith that he memorized and that he knows. And even they said that when he was escaping Al-Ma'mun, you know that they were after him to torture him because of the fitna of Khalq al-Qur'an, to force him to change his opinion regarding whether the Qur'an is revealed or not, and he used to believe in the correct opinion. They said that he hid in a place for 3 days and then he moved. He said the Prophet ﷺ hid in one place before moving to Ghar Hira, and I wanted to follow him. This is an example, and that's why the scholars used to act upon every single hadith that they know of or they were putting much attention, or they used to put the maximum effort in order to act upon every single hadith that they know of, or every single ayah. And that's why normally in the past, my dear respected brothers and sisters, you see the old scholars, the known as classical scholars, such as the a'imma, such as the second generation, or in fact the sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, you see that they used to excel in different fields. You rarely find a scholar who did not participate in jihad. You rarely find this. Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak was one of the greatest scholars of hadith. He participated in jihad. If they do not participate in jihad, you see that they are excelling in many other fields of life, not just only ilm, but in terms of social activism, they used to be very active. In terms of helping others, they used to be very active. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala was a very great scholar. He was involved in so many aspects of life, such as political activism. He participated in jihad. He participated in giving nasiha to the leaders. He was socially active and so on. Why? Ilm encourages people to act. And that's why the scholars used to say that ilm is khashya. This is the meaning of it. We should not think that if you think that you fear Allah Jalla wa Ala, it is sufficient for you. Moreover, my dear respected brothers and sisters, one of the main benefits of ilm, another benefit other than increases the iman, ilm increases the amount of good deeds that you may do. In many cases, you might not be able to do good deeds because you don't, in many cases, you are unaware of many good deeds, many opportunities. Take for example, the virtues of saying Subhanallah wa bihamdihi Subhanallah al-Azim. If you don't know it, you don't say it. Take for example the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sahbihi wasallam, when he said that the one who says Subhanallah wa bihamdihi in the morning 100 times and in the evening 100 times, no one will supersede him on the day of resurrection except a person who said like what he said and more. Subhanallah. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi takes 2 minutes exactly. If you say Subhanallah wa bihamdi, Subhanallah wa bihamdi, Subhanallah wa bihamdi, on that speed it will take 2 minutes from you in the morning and in the evening. If you say this, no one will become with a better deed on the day of resurrection as your deed. If you don't know it, you will not say it. Of course, I'm not saying, my dear respected brothers and sisters, that is the only element that you need to know in order to do. This is one thing, but you need many other things in order to act upon your knowledge. But knowledge is the first step. Also, knowledge, my dear respected brothers and sisters, helps you to achieve what you cannot achieve by your actual deeds. Look in Hadith Abi Kamsha Al-Anmari radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam said, a long hadith, but I will just quote what is really important here. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا الدُّنْيَا لِأَرْبَعَةِ نَفَرٍ. The life is divided among four people. The first type is a person whom Allah jalla wa ala gave him knowledge and gave him wealth. Because of knowledge and wisdom, he knows how to spend the money in the best way. That's why the Prophet ﷺ said he is, or he will be, in the highest position. The second one is a person who was given knowledge and wisdom, but he was not given money or wealth. Now, because of the wisdom that he has given, because of the knowledge that he has given, he would say, Oh Allah, had I been given what the other person was given, I would have done what he is doing. So now, because of the knowledge and the wisdom that he was given, he is saying this, and Allah Jalla wa Ala will place him in the same position. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, they are going to be in the same position. Look, in the other side, The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the third person, a person who was given wealth, but he was not given wisdom. Now, if you say wisdom or knowledge, they are all linked to each other, generally speaking. Generally speaking, they are linked to each other. So, the other person or the third person was given what? Was given money, but was not given wealth. So, he is using the wealth to what? To do all bad deeds, all evil deeds. He will be what? In the lowest part of the fire of hell. The fourth person is a person who was not given wealth, and he was not given knowledge. He was not given wisdom. He has no wisdom. What is he saying? Because of the level of ignorance he had, he would say, oh, if I have the same amount of wealth, if I am wealthy enough, I would do as what this person is doing. I will do all the evil deeds. And this is what we see in the society. Many poor people, they look up at the rich people who are evil and rich, and they say, oh, we wish if we had this amount of money, we would have done this and that, and we would have committed all these sins that those rich people are committing. What did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say about the third person and the fourth person? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about the fourth person, he will be placed next to the third person. They will be in the same level of the fire of hell. Why is this? It is knowledge, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Now, I was talking about knowledge and wisdom. See, when we say that you need to study and you need to learn, we are saying that you need to learn and you need to put what you learn into practice. And once you learn, provided that you are learning to put what you studied into practice in order to please Allah Jalla wa Ala, Allah Jalla wa Ala will give you the light. Imam Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, indeed, the ilm, the real ilm is nur, is a light that Allah Jalla wa Ala gives the person in his heart. How? It is a light that Allah Jalla wa Ala gives in the heart because the person is studying for the sake of Allah Jalla wa Ala, and he wants to put whatever he learned into practice. That's why ilm becomes a light for him. Remember, whenever you go in order to seek knowledge, you are going in the path of Jannah. Jazakumullahu khaira. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Blessings be upon Nabi, peace be upon the Messenger, and the prophets who were sent, all of them were honored. Peace be upon the Messenger, and the prophets who were sent, all of them were honored. Mukramun, blessings be upon Nabi, peace be upon the Messenger, and the prophets who were sent, all of them were honored.